here.
So what was left over.
Oh, so you didn't go and cut holes?
Oh, no.
I was a little bit worried for a moment. Now, you, about redecorating. Tell me your story about redecorating.
Well, I kept nagging my husband to do some decorating, and he wouldn't. So I decided I'd do it myself. So I started off in the bathroom, which didn't turn out too good, a bit of a disaster. But he redid it again.
He did. You had to cover up all your mistakes with it, didn't you? Mm.
Okay, last but by no means least. I'm sorry. I have to say that. It looks disgusting. One by one, we'll end on that one. What's that one?
Meatballs.
Yes, yuck. And that's one?
Van leaves.
I'm not going yuck because they probably taste very nice, but cold and congealed. Yes. Vine leaves. This is what you'd usually eat? Favourite meal?
The Greek meals, yeah.
The Greek meals. Yeah. But you all enjoy this, don't you?
Oh, yes.
And this one?
It's lamb.
Lovely. And then, last but by no means. Osaka. How many days old is that?
Yesterday, aren't I?
Oh, yesterday. About 5 days, but I didn't say that. Cameron, thank you very much. Now we know more about the family of the week. But now it's time to go upstairs to the crunch with Zig and Zag.
It's Monday!
It's sunny,
isn't it? It's
week two
after summer holidays. It is Mrs. Smith. Get up, heaven's sake.
For goodness sake!
Today's special guest with Zig and Zag, Linford Chrissy's going to be here later. Yay! Linford, look at the time. You're too early. Look at the time. Blimey, all right. You're going to have a cup of tea or something.
You're too early.
Bad mail time.
This is brilliant. Claire Hopkins said this in, and she's standing. She coloured me in. And even Stephen. Look, it's brilliant. And it's got me in my
underlines, Chris.
And there's one of my brothers. That's my brother. His name's Zag.
I don't look too happy, though. It looks as though maybe Sidney Crawford wouldn't go out with me that evening.
That particular day. But she's been out with you since, though.
Yes, several times, Christopher. Chris, you see this here?
Right, what?
This is a very clever thing.
He wasn't joining in viewers. I had to do it.
Peter Sargent and Ian Turnberry from Allerton High School in Leeds. Thanks a mil.
What is it?
It's a me cushion.
A me? But if you sat on that, you'd get a bit of a surprise, wouldn't you? Thanks anyway. It's a beautiful, beautiful thing. Thanks. Okay,
Please, no.
Some Mad Mail. Got to see the rest. Some Mad Mail. Hang on a minute. This is the holiday horrors.
Chris, what? Oh, yeah. Just to pick it up there.
Vandalized.
Okay. Don't let Zig show his collections.
The crunch, yeah, the big breath. Look, it's a dope one.
Ring!
It's like a mad thing!
No, don't let him show it. No.
It's not so boring.
Can I show my collection now, please?
What is it?
My collection of crusts. From sandwiches.
You were right,
Dad. A small collection of crusts from sandwiches.
You won't.
Have a look at these. The first one, right? Egg and cucumber.
Okay.
I know that one on the train.
Okay.
From the train. This one here, right? Mm-hmm. This one is Bovril and tomato. And this one's peanut butter and sandwich spread.
Hang on a minute. Everybody, hang on just 1 minute. These look like they've been carefully crafted by the props department.
No! Zig, tell the truth!
It's a fake collection!
Tell the truth!
Wait 1 minute, right?
Who eats a crust like that?
Nobody!
Okay. Right, that's a very good phenomenal explanation.
What's that?
My collections are far too valuable to bring all the way in the back seat of a taxi into this program.
That
they
is
stay
true.
At home!
It's true!
He got out of it well. Please. He got out of that very well.
Well, thank you, Mr.
So, later on...
Turn that Hoover off this minute!
We're going to meet Limpid Christie, aren't we? That's going to be really exciting.
Yes, indeed!
But first of all, we have the washing line.
Washing line!
Then we have Fender Bender 500. But now, we have a question about the clip. The question about the clip is,
what did he do? And remember, please, do not phone. It's just for fun.
Wayne, where is Adam?
Well,
Who is that man in the van? And where did this bunny come from?
All right, I confess, I did it.
Did what?
Way down deep in the middle of the Congo, a hippo took an apricot, a clover, and a mango. He stuck it with the others and he danced a dizzy tango. The rhino said, I know, we'll call it Umbongo. Umbongo, little kid, and he...
officially? Nikki Taylor is officially still happy.
Yes, she's smiling.
Will, yeah. Will, yeah. What are you saying?
Well,
what?
If we could help out with the problem.
Yeah. Okay, the boys are willing to talk to you about that problem anytime you like. But now we've got to go upstairs and Linford Christie meets Zig and Zag. Watch this.
Wow.
Than any other British male athlete.
Yeah!
And not a lot of people know this, but he's 8'6" tall. That's pretty tall, missus! Wow. He's one of the fastest men in the world! Woo. See that? See that? That was
he ran in
there
just like that. He was
so Linford!
So quick.
Yeah.
Yep, pretty cool.
I've always wanted to ask this question, and it's a question that many of the viewers wanted me to ask on behalf of them. And that is, Linford, did you always want to be one of the fastest men in the world?
Terrible question. And by the way, you made a little bit of a faux pas, Zaggy baby.
A what?
I made one of those last week, but it went all soggy.
Did he really?
Yeah.
Well, this particular one didn't go soggy because you said one of the fastest men in the world.
The.
That's right. That's right. The fastest man in the world. Wow. In our bathroom right now. It's
the fastest man in the world.
What we want to know is, can you do a wahey? All right, and so what you did is very simple. Should we all do it together? Yeah. One, two, three.
Wahey!
He can do it!
Yes!
Okay, we got five questions for you. Okay, do we want to clear anything else up, or can we get into the cards now?
No, we're fine.
Okay. Are you sure? Okay. Thank you very much indeed.
So this is Linford Christie, fastest man in the world. No point in hanging around.
No, boy.
Dilly-dallying or any of that block.
No.
Linford, you are the fastest man in the world. I'll say that again. And your fastest speed is 9.92 seconds. What is that in miles per hour?
Just about 22.68 miles per hour.
Blimey!
It is! Okay. Linford, you are the fastest man in the world.
Whoa. Okay.
Now, we would like to know what the weather is like in Glasgow. Can you help us out with that?
I can help you out with that.
Go on then, go! And the answer is?
Quick.
It's a bit cold.
Oh! He's the fastest man in the world!
In the world!
Okay.
In the world!
Question number three.
Linford Intercity Critzy, that's what they call it. Okay, Linford, you are the fastest man in the world. Exactly how smelly do your socks actually get? Well, that's a good question.
Woo!
Oh, Chris, I need water!
The problem is...
No, it's not suede. We know what suede is.
I'm allergic to cheese.
We have actually three pairs of Linford, or three socks here from Linford's races. Oh. Which race was this from, Linford?
This is the Olympic side. This is definitely Olympic side.
Okay. Oh. That went very fast.
Oh.
Okay.
Okay.
And this one?
Well, this was a Commonwealth sock. Definitely.
Commonwealth.
Oh. That looks deceptively clean, Chris, but in fact it is see-through. It used to be a black sock.
Oh. Now,
and Linford...
If you've got Nikon stereo, just get very close to your TV.
Can we talk about this, Linford? Linford?
Linford.
Can we talk about this problem that you may have in your private life?
I was keeping. This was one of my... This is my secret socks.
Now, where do these smell most? At the bottom, of course! Of course!
At the bottom!
My mum wouldn't like to hear that, Chris Evans.
Well, I shan't say it again. Okay, we have another question for you.
Linford Christie, fastest man in the world. Linford, you're the fastest man in the world, I said it again. Can you recreate a relay race for us now?
And we're all going to
be. Definitely.
We need a baton.
A what baton?
Right.
Cool baton.
Here we go.
Who's going to do the first leg?
Well, I'll do the first leg. I usually run last leg, but this time.
Okay. Are you marked? Get set.
Go!
Go, Zaggy!
Scotland, I'm sure he is.
The baton.
Ran down to, where was the place? Leighton Buzzard and Corp Boot Sale. Yeah. I got there 20p for it.
Oh, no.
Well, I thought it might be a good idea. We could use it maybe.
We wouldn't win a race like that, Christopher, with that kind of
action. Where's my share then?
That was commercially dropping the baton.
Certainly
for financial gain.
We wouldn't win any races that way. Don't worry, I didn't really sell it.
Oh, it was just me
having a little joke. I was only playing a joke at all of you.
We need the button back for question number five.
Linford, you are the fastest man in the world. That's true. I'll also repeat that because my brother said it quite a few times.
Fastest man in the world.
Can you conduct the music with that baton?
No, he made that question.
Wait.
So, go on, Jack,
I didn't even want to ask that question because it's embarrassing. Because we all know that there's two types, a baton for conducting and then a baton. Let me try. What?
Big Breakfast. We want to know what you do to cheer yourself up. Stephanie Coles from Bristol. To cheer myself up, I put on full red Indian wall paint and I go to my local supermarket. You are strange, Stephanie. Gareth Sumley from Kunluck says, to cheer myself up, I talk to my cabbages. Okay. Right. Simon Gander from Hockley says, to cheer myself up, I play the piano with my cat. Yeah. Just use your hands next time. Bum, bum. Right, to cheer myself up, we are going to get somebody wet. Hello.
Hi.
Right, we are going to get one member of the Big Breakfast crew soaking, dripping, wet.
Whoa.
We've got 8 straws, 8 people. We would like you each now to pick a straw, and whoever gets a short straw goes in the water. Time for Let's Get Wet, come on. Go on. Okay, put the straws together.